Okay, this sermon is entitled Wordless Testimonies. I'd like to open up with prayer, and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners, I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 118 reads, O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever. Let Israel now say that his mercy endureth forever. Let the house of Aaron now say that his mercy endureth forever. Now, the Bible makes it very clear that you have to have God's word in order to be saved. There are lots of people out there, sad to say, that have a so-called testimony that is devoid of God's word. Now, I would actually prefer to dub it a testiphony or a testabaloney. And that's when people base their salvation on some type of an emotional experience, or maybe it's an epiphany or a theophany, or they just had a changed life, and they're deceiving themselves into thinking that, well, that's how I got saved. Or they've turned from their sins, or they've turned over a new leaf, or whatever. But see, these things do not save anyone. The only way to be saved is through God's word. Now turn over to Romans chapter number 10. In Romans chapter 10, we see in verse 17, and it reads, it says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So you can't have faith in Christ unless you hear the word of God. Turn back to John chapter 5. In John chapter 5, Jesus himself is saying that we don't need the testimony of man. We need the testimony of God. Now that's why we have all this false doctrine. That's why it's so rife in this world, is because people are using man-made rhetoric, man-made jargon. And that's why we have stuff like, you know, turn from your sins, repent of your sins, make Christ the Lord of your life, this lordship garbage, or give your life to Jesus. These things do not come from the scripture. Now it says in John chapter 5 and verse 34, it says, but I receive not testimony. Saved, a person has to have the word of God. Now this is also kind of an acid test to find out if somebody's a false convert or not. Okay, if you ask somebody, what verse did you get saved by? They may not remember, you know, the exact verse, but they'll understand the concept of the verse. If they say, well, there was no verse, then they probably weren't saved at all. Because you have to have God's word that you might be saved. Now jump back to John 5:24, and it reads, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Now notice the emphasis is on hearing the word. The word needs to be preached, or the word needs to be presented from the King James Bible. And that's why testimonies that are devoid or bereft of God's word are fake testimonies. Now turn over to 1 Corinthians, and let's take a look at a couple more verses, and then I'll close. In 1 Corinthians chapter 1, we see this concept again. It says in verse 17, it says, for Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect. See, this is why it's important to quote God's word verbatim. Don't use man-made words like I've already demonstrated. Verse 18 reads, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. These unsaved false converts out there, they don't believe in the cross. They don't. To them it's meaningless. It's foolishness to them. It's a bunch of gobbledygook. But see, then it goes on to say, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. See, the gospel is the power of God into salvation. So that's why we need the preaching of God's word in order to be saved, or we need to hear God's word. And that's why it's important that a person has scripture in their testimony instead of just some vague story or some anecdote about how they had an experience at some point. That's not going to fly. So we need God's word. And that's why it's important whenever we witness to others, we use God's word as well. Like verses in John, like John 3:15, John 3:16, John 3:36, John 6:35, John 6:40, John 6:47, Acts 16:31, etc., etc. So that's all I have. We need to watch out for these wordless testimonies because they're totally anti-biblical. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Bless the listeners, I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.